Thank you for joining us. This is Orbit Network Training, Section 3, connecting to the Protocol Interface Module, which is what we also call the PIM. This section will basically have two parts. First is setting up the PIM with the software pack that Solartron provides. We'll just briefly discuss powering the probes as well as setting an IP address. Then in part B, we're just going to do a quick example of taking probe readings from the PIM using a PLC. This is actually going to be assisted by Pixis Technologies out of Plymouth, Michigan in USA. Now, please note, this section does not cover any examples of programming or configuration of PLCs. For that, please consult your system's documentation. It should be noted, too, there's already training on Orbit GCS software, Excel add-in software, as well as the digital input-output module. And again, all of these are located on our YouTube channel, so you can click on the link above or go to solartronmetrology.com for a link. So before we get started, how about just a quick technical review? First, the protocol interface module, what it in essence does is basically translate the Orbit protocol into a variety of PLC protocols. And then it will just send the raw readings from these sensors to the PLC on command. And we actually have several different types of PIMs. The PIM for Ethernet IP, one for Profinet, one for EtherCAT, one for CC-Link, which should be available in late 2021, as well as a PIM for Modbus over TCP IP. Now, if you wish to communicate with a PLC that operates Modbus over serial, we have an interface module for that as well, which we term the modem. Now here's the back of a PIM, and there's just a couple of basic components. First, of course, is the power. Solartron does supply a power pack that you can plug into a wall, but if you want to connect directly to it, you just need to have 18 to 32 volts of DC power. There's also a mini USB port. This is for configuring the PIM. We'll talk about that in a second. Then there is the top screen, which basically just is a monitoring device where you can just see the address, see any Bluetooth IDs, as well as the number of Orbit modules. Now, in terms of powering the Orbit modules, the PIM itself with the DC power will power up to 10 Orbit modules or up to 4 lasers. Now, if it's more than 10, all you have to do is add a standard PSIM to the stack and then just continue to add modules like so. Now, the PIM does run most Orbit modules, such as the analog interface module. Like here, there's an example where it's connected to a thermocouple, or also it will connect to the wireless connection module, and then you can bring in readings from a Wii gauge. There are some exceptions. One is the digital input-output module, as well as the digimatic interface module. Now, just a quick review. One of the things that's discussed frequently about connecting to the PLC is explicit versus implicit messaging. You know, explicit messaging is basically a request reply type action from the PLC. And with this, you can access a large amount of data. And so with this, you can actually directly read individual probes on an Orbit network. So let's say you just want a reading from like the fifth probe, you know, loaded onto the Orbit stack. You can do a send or receive type command for that. So this is the best method if you want to communicate with certain Orbit modules, but not all of them. But it should be noted that with this mode, you can't really synchronize several modules at once, but you have more parameterized information available. So with this particular mode, you can do up to 150 sensors with a PIM. Then there is implicit messaging, which is also called cyclic messaging or IO messaging. Now, this is basically just a block read or write of synchronized data. It's basically equivalent to an Orbit read burst function. And in fact, that command is used with inside the PIM to pull the data from the Orbit probes. So here you have synchronized readings being sent to the PLC. It is faster than explicit, but less information is available than explicit. So with the implicit mode, you can do up to 50 sensors with the protocol interface module. Now, the first thing you will want to do is actually go to the Solartron website and actually download our latest support pack. And with that, you get the Orbit suite, if you haven't done this already. So for that, go to solartronmetrology.com, go to service and support, drivers and software, and then download Orbit 3 support pack for Windows. Now, once you have opened the Orbit suite, you will come to this main page here. And the key thing you'll want to focus on is this PIM utility. But before we get started and setting up the PIM, first let's click on manuals, and then you'll see that the both the user manual and the datasheet manual are in the lower left-hand corner. So here's the PIM user manual, which is in PDF. And then the datasheet manager. And here, this will have the maps as well as the electronic datasheets for all of the different protocols available. So for example, let's open up the PIM ADI map for all available data. And here you'll see the different commands as well as channel one readings. Now, before we click on the PIM utility, the first thing you're actually going to want to do is, of course, build your Orbit stack, you know, connect the probes that you intend to use to the PIM, and then of course, power up the PIM, and then take the USB to mini USB cable, plug the mini USB part into the back of the PIM, and then plug the regular USB side into your computer. So now, when you first click on it, you're going to have a basic screen like this. Just go to select device, and then the particular PIM you intend to use should pop up here. Click select. So then you have a home screen like this. And here you have just a couple of basic settings. First, over here, this shows the firmware version of the PIM. And then this is a button where if you just want to wipe the memory clean for the PIM, you can just click perform factory reset. In addition, this is the display orientation, and that has to do with the display on top of the module in case you wanted to change it to 90 degrees or 180 degrees if it's perhaps mounted in a cabinet in a certain way. Then down here, this is a particular window for the Bluetooth channel configurations. And this is where if the PIM is connected to a wireless connection module, and then you are communicating with a Wi gauge or a multi-channel Wi gauge. And here you can scan network for channels, add ID manually, those types of things. So here we're going to set up some probes. For that, we're going to click connect to Orbit network. Okay, so here is the configurator screen. Now, the first thing you'll see is on the left-hand side here, you'll see a list of the modules that are connected. Here we have two particular digital probes. Now, the software should automatically ping what probes are on the network, but in case there aren't any listed there, you can just click find all modules, or perhaps if you have, you know, added some to the stack, again, you can click find all modules or press probe to add. If you wish to just clear it and start over, you can of course click clear all modules. Now, the order of these here is actually quite critical. If you'll see how there's a serial number for the probe listed here, but then next to it, you have 001 or 002. This is what the PLC is going to use to communicate or perhaps draw a reading from those particular digital probes or modules. So if a PLC wants to get a reading from Orbit Module 1, it's going to be this particular one here, or this will be designated Orbit Module 2. Now, if for whatever reason you want to change the order of these, all you have to do is highlight it and then drag it into the particular spot you want. Like for example, the DP2 is now Orbit Module 1 in this case. Also, when you have these highlighted, you can actually change the settings if you wish, such as the resolution or the averaging. Now, if you have an encoder interface module connected to the protocol interface module, here is where you can change those particular settings, input type as well as quadrature type. For more information on this, you can go to the encoder interface module section of the Orbit manuals. Now, once you are all set up here, then you click send changes and settings to the device. So now it's saved into the memory of the protocol interface module. Now there's a few other features as well. First, we're going to click disconnect from the Orbit network. And then there's Orbit monitor. And this is just a quick, easy way to basically check on the digital probes themselves. Like for example, for Orbit channel 1, let's just press the probe tip there. Orbit channel 2. In addition, you have a command here where you can reset the max and the min. Then the third tab here is the configuration. And in this case, this is the Ethernet IP configuration. Now, if you'll see the network configuration, you have the host name, you have the IP address, and this is where actually manually, if you want to enter it, you can do it right here. to whatever number suffices. Or if you want the network, if the PIM is connected to a network and you want that to assign an address, then you just click this box. DHCP means Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. And again, you have host name, IP address, subnet mask, and default gateway. Then once you have this all set, you can click Write Configuration to Device. Click Yes. It should be noted too that you have the current network state. So if the PIM is connected into a network, that will display here, including the network settings that are in use. Then once you are done, click Select Device and Disconnect. Please note also that the screen at the top of the PIM has multiple status indicators, such as for the network, the orbit status, and you can also check the status of each probe. Now we will move on to part B, an example of taking probe readings from a PIM using a PLC. And assisting with this exercise is Pixis Technologies out of Plymouth, Michigan in the USA. For more information, go to pixistechnologies.com. Now first, let's go back to the PIM configuration and diagnostics utility. The customer has gone back here. They're going to name the host name PIM, and then enter a particular IP address, subnet mask, and default gateway, and then configure that to the device. But now if you'll see, it's actually connected to a PLC over the network, and there's a link detected as well as an IP established. And if you'll notice too, the IP address here matches the IP address that has been uploaded to the PIM. Now here's a configuration screen within the setup software for the PLC. Here you have an Ethernet module, generic, and then the name of it is just given S17C, Solartron Probes. This is basically the designated name for the PIM. And if you'll note too, under description, the part number is matched. Also, the IP address matches what has been uploaded to the PIM. And then over here, you have the connection parameters, namely the assembly instances for input, output, and configuration. Assemblies, again, are predefined collections of data residing in an adapter. Now, here's an exercise just with I/O mapping for taking readings from the probe. If you'll notice on the upper right-hand side, you have the source as well as the destination. And then you have three probes set up. Here's a 10 millimeter probe. And then the destination has a designation of 0. Then the second probe has a destination with a designation of 1. Then the third has a destination or designation of 2. And then the third row down here is actually offset values. So let's say you don't want to take the raw readings from the probe, like 0 to 10, but actually have an offset value. Like for example, here, an offset value is entered of 17.5 for both the first probe and the second probe. Then the third probe has an offset of 2.26. So now individual readings are being taken from each particular probe, including the offset values. Now, again, it should be noted for actual programming with the PIM in relation to the PLC, please consult the documentation of your particular PLC. So that concludes Section 3 training, connecting to a protocol interface module. And again, it had two portions. First was setting up a PIM with the Solartron provided software package. And then part B was just an example of taking probe readings from a PIM using a PLC. Thanks again to Pixis Technologies for their assistance on this. Again, there are other Orbit training sections. Section 1, Orbit Basics. Section 2, Connecting Orbit to Software. And then, of course, Section 4, Connecting to Solartron Wireless Products. It should be noted too that all training videos are loaded onto the Solartron Metrology YouTube channel. The playlist is shown here and includes videos for the Orbit Network, as well as Orbit GCS, Orbit Excel, the Digital Input Output Module, and others are added daily. You can either click on the link below or go to solartronmetrology.com and click on the YouTube link. Thank you and have a good day.